Speaking during the Uganda Martyrs Day service at the Anglican Martyrs site, the vicar of the site, Reverend Esau Bosa Chimanje, disclosed that most of the land belonging to the Church of Uganda at Namugongo has been encroached on by unknown people, a thing that has stalled church projects. He appealed to the government to intervene in this matter.
We had a very big chunk of land. The people who are seated behind the church, all are on church land. We are squeezed. Our church we are putting up, it is squeezed. Squeezed because of the challenge. Our neighbors behind cannot go away. So we are appealing to you. Maybe you can appeal to the government to do something.
In response, the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabirwa, who represented President Museveni, said government will investigate the matter, and if the occupants of the said land are found to be bona fide or lawfully occupying the land, the government will consider paying them off such that the church can fully utilize its land.
There was also mention about the good neighbors who are sitting on church land. I want to assure you, the principal, I think, is the one who mentioned it, that if they are bona fide occupants, we have to make sure that they are handled as bona fide occupants. And because this place is a government place, it contributes towards religious tourism. I think if we proposed for government to help us on compensating the bona fide occupants around this place, that proposal must be supported.
The church also complained of the exorbitant expenditures on utility bills, especially electricity. It is considering fundraising for a solar-powered lighting system.
We want to thank God for this new project which we are launching today. It is using umeme. But I know we have been battling with the bills of umeme. So, and I know if we are to continue with umeme, we are going to suffer.
The government is planning to make sure that we put money in the energy fund so that we stop borrowing money to go for generation of electricity. Borrowed money contribute 60% of the tariff of electricity.
In the president's message to the pilgrims, read by the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Ruth Nankabirwa, Ugandans were urged to embrace wealth creation projects to develop socially and economically.
It is important for all households to join the wealth creation campaign in order to guarantee prosperity. The NRM government is mobilizing the remaining 39% of the Ugandan households that are still trapped in subsistence farming, that is working only for food, to join the money economy.
The chairperson of the organizing committee, First Deputy Prime Minister Rebecca Kadaga, thanked everyone that worked so hard to ensure this year's celebration was a success. She also upgraded the congregation on the progress of the construction of the church house.
We have completed the work on the capstone and the drainage and work with stone pitching. Those have been done. Marmoran coatings with weather guard acrylic paint has been used to mold the artistic impressions and final finishing. Your Grace, this work totals 250 million shillings.
Archbishop Kazimba implored families to stick together and raise their children with Christian values.
I call even couples and families in marriage to be united for their own sustainable growth. Work together and plan together for your family's future and sustainability.
Meanwhile, Minister Nankabirwa, on behalf of the President, has launched and laid a foundation stone for amphitheatre and Uganda Martyrs VIP roof of 3,000-seater shed that was fundraised by Ankole Diocese. Reports compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.